the past, where we came from, Montana, the last best place, the big sky country, one of the last remaining vestiges of the colorfully fabled and often chronicled Wild West. Beneath the romanticized patina of life in the West lie the real stories of the people that came, betting all or none on the dream this wild land could be tamed. Montana homesteaders got more than they bargained for. The West could never truly be domesticated. Instead, the land bred a wild independence into the marrow of those born and raised here. Grandparents of our not far removed generation lived and toiled in the dirt, rivers, and blood of this young, wild country. Not merely surviving, but thriving in this sparse, hard domain. Skilled and self-reliant, they were taught hard-won lessons of survival of the fittest. The land controls us still, molding and shaping with deft hammer blows, forging our lives. When people ask, "We don't just live in Montana, we are born of Montana. Beautiful but rugged, proud and strong, without pretense, wrought by the land. This is the land of our birth, our home, where it all began." Western lifestyles are considered romantic, but only a handful of people still make a living from the land. With his experience as a rancher and a stockman, Neil Eustance plied his unique skills to start a mule packing service in the wilderness. He contracted with outfitters and the Forest Service to move people and supplies in the Scapegoat Mountains, more than a quarter of a million roadless acres. He logged thousands of miles on horseback, roving the backcountry until the wilderness trails and inhabitants were as familiar and welcome as most people's homes. His business began to grow quickly, and he needed specialized equipment that couldn't be found at the local Western store. Together with his wife Babette, Neil began to design and build the saddles and tack that their packing business needed. Eustance Pack and Tack was born. Along with hunting and horses, saddle building became part of Neil's Western Renaissance. The Eustances had a lot of experience with outfitting camps in the Scapegoat, and when an outfitter decided to sell his camp, they made a deal. The Sheep Creek Camp offered some of the best hunting around. The Montana Board of Outfitters and the Forest Service approved Neil's license, and in 1998, Eustance Pack and Tack Outfitters began operations. Neil was destined for success. The old adage of find a job you love and never work again a day in your life holds true. A labor of love shows the quality and dedication that no other profession can achieve. To the Eustance family, outfitting isn't just what they do, it's who they are. Eustance Pack and Tack Outfitters is truly an anachronism in today's world. These hunts are like an expedition to a foreign land. Only non-motorized travel is permitted. No machinery or wheeled vehicles are allowed. Horses and hiking boots take the place of 4x4s. Cross-cut saws and elbow grease take the place of chainsaws. All structures must be temporary and removed at the end of the season. The area hunted is genuinely wild. Archaeological studies done in the Scapegoat area found evidence of nomadic peoples using this area as a hunting ground 10,000 years ago. When you place your footsteps on the wind-swept shale ridges of the Rocky Mountains and scan the dark timber below, you share not just a feast of scenery, but an abiding sense of sovereignty felt by countless generations of hunters.
Besides the obvious thing, everyone talks about elk. They want to get an elk or a deer. I'm not sure that everyone realizes it's the largest complex of wilderness areas in the lower continental United States. And so there's going to be very rare opportunities for someone to have an experience like this in terms of being this remote in the United States, except if you were to go to Alaska. So that's something that I don't think everyone fully appreciates and understands. when they have an opportunity to come on a trip like this, it's really a once in a lifetime opportunity to be in a primitive area. In many respects, it's been very lightly, if not touched, by the hand of man. It's one of the last places left in the United States, and people really need to understand that because it needs to be protected. And it's the resource that allows people to have this incredible experience. This is the Scapegoat Wilderness is part of the largest wilderness complex in the United States. It joins with the Bob Marshall and the Great Bear, and also the Sun River Game Preserve. It's one of the only places left in the United States where the Rocky Mountain front, where the Great Plains meets the foothills of the Rocky Mountain shelf, and then you go into the Rocky Mountains, that exists in a primitive form anywhere in the United States. And so you have those three wilderness complex all share boundaries, and then they're joined up with Glacier National Park. And so you can literally go from Highway 200 at Lincoln all the way to Canada through this wilderness area and cross only one highway. That's the highway that goes between Kalispell and Browning, and that divides the Bob Marshall Wilderness and the Glacier Park. So there's nowhere in the United States like this because of the configuration of Congress setting aside these wilderness areas one after another and putting them side by side. Then in addition to, and you notice this at the trailhead, each of these wilderness areas is protected by a band of national forest land. And so that's why this area is so primitive and rugged, because it's so protected from roads and the influences of modern civilization. Keeps it really rugged. Opportunity to not only see a lot of mule deer, whitetail elk, but also wolves, mountain lions, black bear, grizzly bear. It truly is one of the last primitive areas left in the United States. So it makes for an incredibly unique hunting experience. When you're out here, even in this main camp, you're more remote than most people will ever have an opportunity to be in their lifetime. And then, of course, when you go out each day for the hunt, you're more remote than most people will ever be. And just the ability to have someone take you out to those areas, whether you actually see game or not, it's going to be an opportunity of a lifetime.
The entire Eustance Pack and Tack team is dedicated to preserving the knowledge and skills to safely provide clients with an unforgettable, traditional, and by definition, primitive experience. So just what are you in for? Primitive, but by no means uncomfortable. The Sheep Creek Camp is located about 8 miles into the wilderness. After wrapping all the gear and hanging the mantis on the mules, camp is less than a 3-hour ride on horseback. A small village of canvas wall tents sits in a sunny meadow bisected by a clear spring-fed stream. The lodge-like kitchen tent is the epicenter of camp life, where a barrel stove puffs the aromas of cowboy coffee and wood smoke. Guest tents offer comfortable respite from a long day's hunt. In the evening, the soft lantern glow illuminates faces over great food and wild adventures recounted. Mornings come early. Anxious minds rouse tired bodies from their cots. Eggs crack to the rhythm of boiling coffee and frying bacon. Everyone packs sandwiches and snacks. After breakfast, the guides gear up with bugles, fanny packs, and tools of the trade before heading to the horses. Headlamp beams trace wobbly orbits through the dark, while hunters and guides file quietly away on the pre-dawn trails, hustling to get to the magic spot.
It really is, by definition, not a human place, and so it's hard for a lot of people to understand what it's like before they get here. It's very remote, very little amenity, kind of what makes it special. There's a lot of hunting camps, and there's a lot of places in Montana especially that are beautiful. But the fact that this is really what nature is in its rawest form, you know, you use grandeur and all these big words, but when you're out here in this big open spot, and you really kind of feel insignificant, but still it's empowering. You're in this big wild spot, and I'm making it, I'm doing it. Look at the things that I'm capable of. So it gives you a greater respect for the game that you're hunting. A lot of, you know, modern television programs, except the hunting channels and all that show just the little clips of this is the animal, this is the guys with the guns, and they shoot it, it's on the ground, it's yay, everybody's happy, and there's so much more in between all that happens, especially in a wilderness area, in a wilderness camp.
Thank you. We're back. September 25th. My second bull. Good old Montana. It's a nice 6x6 with my guy Jeremy Webb. Beautiful 6x6. Textbook hunt. Bugled. Had him going. Nice forks on the back. About a 350, 400 yard shot. Hit him good, he dropped, and here we go. We're back. What do you got to say, Jeremy?
Good times, man.
Good times, my buddy. First bull with me and Jeremy.
Four bulls.
Yep. Four bulls, about 60 head of elk. And here on this trail, going right up the canyon there, and I shot him all the way up there. On that hill up top there. There we go. Nice 6x6. Man, life is good. Thank you, elk, for providing this meat.
Why choose us? At Eustance Pack and Tack, we try harder because we love what we do. Our crew is the best in the industry, and still they strive to improve. Our small family operation treats all of their clients with the utmost respect. Our return customers become part of our wilderness family. The guides know the area and work together to give everyone the best opportunity to tag out. Not only do we provide one of the most fascinating and challenging hunts available on the North American continent, we do it while keeping you safe and comfortable. And we have a lot of elk. Currently, Montana is home to an estimated 160,000 elk. This is as large a herd there's been since the state was first settled. And don't forget, our mule deer populations are knockout. Hunting in the wilderness is different than most modern hunting opportunities. Though this is a public land hunt, the remoteness means less hunting pressure. This is the most traditional kind of hunt, bringing new meaning to the term fair chase. It's an exhibition that is an unrivaled adventure, more beautiful than you can imagine, and a challenge that, if met, changes people forever. Hunting with Eustance Pack and Tack may not be for everyone, but for those who have high expectations for themselves as sportsmen, there is nothing that compares to hunting truly wild Rocky Mountain elk.
What I like about this hunt the most is just being outdoors, just the beauty of the nature out here, the wilderness, and just the beautiful country you see. It's just a gorgeous place, and it's a true outdoor experience, and just can't beat it. Yeah, I got an elk on this trip. I got a nice 6x6. On the first day, it was a great hunt, textbook hunt. And I'm real happy and saw a lot of elk, saw about 60 elk the first day, and it was a great hunt. Get in shape, get ready to hike a lot, get ready to hunt hard. It's no Hollywood hunt, it's the best experience ever. You get to experience beautiful nature, the wilderness, and if you do get rewarded with an elk, it's the best feeling ever. Bobette and Neil have a great operation here. It's all first class. great food, they're great guides, they have a great camp here, and they run a solid operation. And their location here is great for hunting, a lot of animals, and it's a first-class operation.
Other things you should know. The day's hunt typically consists of riding to an area, glassing and hiking on foot, then a ride home in the evening. Most days plan to be out of the camp the entire day. This area is large, big sky and big land to go with it. This means more opportunity for game, but takes travel time. This is where pre-season workouts and conditioning pay off. The better physical shape you're in, the more efficiently you can travel. Several different tactics are used depending on whether you're hunting the ridges, down in the river bottoms, in the old burn, or the thick green timber. It all depends on where elk have been scouted and what the weather's like. Bugle conditions make getting close to elk possible, but we know where to look if they don't come to us. This is the Wild West as it is today. When you're ready for the adventure, we're ready to guide you.